This training video from the Penn State Institute for Cyber Science is designed to help you work with our high-performance computing system, the Advanced Cyber Infrastructure, or ICS-ACI. In this video, you'll learn how to use FileZilla on the ICS-ACI system. FileZilla is a free commercial software product that lets you make a connection to a remote system so you can transfer and manage files. You can download FileZilla at this website. FileZilla is available for both Windows and Mac operating systems. Download the installer you want, then click on the downloaded file to start the installation process. You'll be taken through a step-by-step installation process, and you'll be able to modify the installation directories according to your preferences. If you need help with the installation process, check the FileZilla webpage. Once the installation process is complete, you're ready to start using the FileZilla application. In the Host field, enter the host name of the cluster you want to connect to. That's acib.aci.ics.psu.edu. Enter your Penn State user ID and your password in the respective fields. Then enter the port number. For SSH protocol, SCP, the default port number is 22. You'll only need to specify some other port number if the server is using a non-standard protocol. Now click on Quick Connect. You're given the option to save or not save your password. We strongly recommend that you do not save your password. If you're logging into the server for the first time, you'll be asked to accept the host key. Clicking OK accepts the key. Check the box for Trust This Host to save the host key for future sessions. Now Penn State's two-factor authentication system kicks in. A Duo push request is sent to your smartphone. Approve it to connect. Once you're logged in, the panel on the right-hand side of the display will show your remote folder on the server. The left panel displays your local folder. You can upload a file from your local folder to your remote folder with a simple drag and drop operation. Here, we're uploading FileZilla. Information about system actions is shown live in these two panels at the top and bottom of the screen. Just as you can drag and drop files from local to remote, you can do the reverse. Drag and drop to download a file or a directory from your remote folder to your local folder. Here are some other things to notice about the display. At the bottom left in your display, you can click Queued Files to see which of your files are queued up for transfer. Click Failed Transfers to see if any of your transfers failed and why. And click on Successful Transfers to see the details of your completed transfers. If you ever get disconnected, you can reconnect without having to enter all your session details again. You will have to enter your password and go through two-factor authentication. To reconnect, click on the Server tab and then click on Reconnect. Finally, if you're done with your session and ready to disconnect, pull down under the Server tab and click Disconnect. We've got more training videos on our website, ics.psu.edu.